Hello and welcome back to the Model Farm. Today it's day 2, season 1 on the farm. Here we've got Johnny flat out getting out the slurry after a first cut. He's got the 2500 gallon NC tanker, his own tanker, and he's got the lovely John Deere 7810 pulling it. And he's flat out, so yes. He's hoping to get the out farm spread as well today, but I think he thinks he might get the contractors to do that. But here he's got his son in the T6175, but this is the contractor's tanker because he wanted the contractors to do all the out farm slurry and the slurry here, but they're away at silage, so they are, and they don't have the drivers, even though they've got a few tractors lying about. So they said that they could borrow their tanker, and they even offered up a tractor, but Johnny said sure he's got the T6, so he'd use it. So yeah, he's got his son here flat out in the T6, just coming on the gateway. They've just started, so they have, but I think they made a deal with the contractors that the contractors would try and get them to do their out farm story, because that's a long way away, so it isn't. They don't want to be having to just draw on with 2 2,500 gallon tankers. And here we've got Johnny's father in the 7600, as widely requested on TikTok. So when he's just rolling the pit here, and he was just tidying the pit up in the Massey with the front loader, and now he's just rolling the pit in the 7600, even though she's only 2 wheel. Look at the pit though. Even though she's only 2 wheel drive, she's still able to climb it. Like there wasn't a lot of bulk, but they put in a lot of acres, so they did. A lot of acres to put in, a lot of out farm, and they even threw in a few grazing fields. So yeah, because they're still feeding silage bales from last year, and they're thinking about going zero grazing, so they cut a good few grazing fields. So yeah, as I said, the cows are still inside, not a wild lot changed. They're still in the shed, hoping to get them out to some more grazing ground soon, but they're hoping to maybe even buy in a zero grazer, start zero grazing, or either feeding silage all year round, but they think they're going to stop letting them out because it's just too much hassle. And they don't have enough ground near home now. They've bought a lot of ground far away. Now here we've got the contractors, and they're scattered all over the road. And to say they're flat out would probably be an understatement. And you can see a Deutz far up here, but this actually isn't theirs. They've called in the help of another contractor. He's a bit further away, but yeah, they're on a long draw today for a different farmer. And they've actually got 8 drawn. 4 from O'Donovan Agri Contractors, the local contractor. And 4 from Doherty Agri Contractors, who run a fleet of high yard tractors, and they don't really care, they don't really go and make or warranty or anything, they more go for just high yards and cheaper tractors. And they've got 16 ton half pipe cane here. And yeah, here we've got Adam in the 6210R again with the Classic, just coming back for another load. And here we've got Martin in the 6250R with the big 16 ton half pipe. And his lovely 6250R. So he is, and he's flat out. And he's actually racing the Deutz 7 Series with the 16 ton. So the Deutz left a good few minutes beforehand. And look at the 250. She's square catching up to the Deutz. She probably will have caught up by the time they reach the pit. Coming down here now, we've got Ryan in the 6210R with the push-up buck rake, just going to help the JCB 420S, because she's under pressure again today, and the farmer's actually helping, and it's John Deere 6125M with her front loader, but they're just not able to cope, so there's going to be 3 on the pit today. And then here we've got the contractors 195M with the rake, just coming back because they mowed it down 2 days ago, but they want to let it all sit and dry out because he wants to have nice dry silage, and then he just rode it up today. He's just coming back from rolling it up. They're lifting actually 120 acres, so big farm, in fairness, big milking farm, milking over 200 cows. Here we've got Davin in the Fence 724 with the Vicon fast bale, just going out. They left 10 acres across, so they're actually doing 130 acres, but they've left 10 acres for bales, and he's just going to bale that up now in the lovely 724. There you can see him just driving, and with the Vicon fast bale. It's not too heavy a crop, so the wrapper in the back should be able to keep up. Now coming into the contractor's yard, there's a lot of action happening, and you may have been wondering why wasn't Connor on the draw, but the reason for that was because he was out drinking last night, and he had a hangover this morning, and they've actually been going lifting 4 hours, but Connor's only went into the contractor's yard now, and he's just pulling out in his lovely 6150R of the Classic. Martin won't be too happy, the owner. Here we've got Mark, the driver of the Chrome Big M, just sitting beside Dylan, the driver of the Volvo 750. And yet they're just sitting there having a cup of tea and having a chat before Mark goes to mow down the next job. And believe it or not, I'm going to be starting a review series. So on Tuesday, there's going to be a review of a Viking 6250R up. So check that out. And here we've got Mark's big M450 just sitting there, ready to go. Here we've got the contractor's Land Rover just sitting there. It's a 9-seater. They use this for whenever they like leave the machinery at jobs and they come back the next morning because they don't like working all night, but sometimes they do. Thanks for watching the video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, ring the little bell, hit the like button, and yeah, hit subscribe. And videos every Sunday and reviews every Tuesday. And there might be a stop motion up someday. So there might. So yeah, thanks for watching and good luck.